Hi friends, in today's training session we will learn about the configuration and testing of chain pointers for newly created material master records in ECC system. In my last session I had explained how to trigger master data IDOCS when a field is changed in the existing material master records in ECC system. But in real-time business, once after go live, you must also send newly created material master records from ECC to the third-party system, because along with data which changes for the existing materials, the system must also trigger IDOCS with a new material whenever a new material is created in ECC system. In this system, I will explain the small configuration required so that ECC system triggers IDOCS by background job whenever a new material master is created. And before going to the configuration, we should know one very important point. Whenever a new material master record is created, it will create an entry in specific tables as per the views created. The material test will make an entry in MAKT table, basic data 1 and 2 in MARA table, plan data for material in MARC table, storage location data in MARD table, material valuation data in MBEW table, warehouse data in MLGN, storage step data in MLGT, sales data in MVKE, and tax classification data for material in MLGN. So now we will go to the configuration. Here we need only one step of configuration. We need to assign our custom message type to the standard object table sign field in BD52 transaction code. SAP has provided one specific field key for new material creation. So what we need to do here, we need to go to BD52 and just copy the field key for the below tables and standard object material from the entries of the standard message type MATMAS to our custom message type MATMAS underscore 1. Let us go to BD52. Input the standard message type. We can see the entries for standard object material for the field key for the table DMAKT. We'll scroll down. We can make the entry. We can see the entry for table DMLAN for the standard object material. See, this two tables DMAKT and DMLAN are not the transparent tables. They are just structures. SAP has provided structures for these two tables so that in the standard program, the system will pick the entries from standard transparent tables MAKT and MLAN from these structures. If you further scroll down, MARA, for MARA there is an entry for the field key. Further scroll down, MARC table, there is an entry for field key for the MRC table also. If you further scroll down, we will find the entries for the other tables also for the field key and the standard object MATMAS. Now, as I explained here, what we need to do, we need to just copy this field key for all these tables for the object standard object material from the standard message type MATMAS to our custom message type MATMAS underscore 1. I will again go to BD52. I will put the custom message type MATMAS underscore 1. I have copied all the entries for the table DMAKT, DMLAN, MARA, MARC, MARD, MBEW, MLGN, MLGT, and MEKE from the standard message type MATMAS to to our customer system MATMAS underscore 1. There is one more entry, which is the field ZEINR for the table MARA for the standard object material. This one we had made in our earlier session on configuration of chain pointers for IDOCS for the data changes for the existing materials, not for the newly created materials. So all the entries are in place. I mean, the configuration is done. Now we need to test the scenario for one material. So what are the test steps? First, we will create a new material. This will create entries in BDCP2 table. It will create as many columns in the BDCP2 table as the number of tables in which the new entry is created, with processing status blank. Second step, we will create a variant for the program RBDM IDOC in AC38. Third one, as usual, we will run the background job using this variant and the program in SM36. It will create IDOC for the newly created materials, and after the IDOC is created, the processing status of the entries for all the tables, for all columns in BDCP2 table will change to X. And in fourth step, we will check in W02 whether the new IDOC is created and the third party system is updated with the new material master record. And once we see the IDOC for the newly created material, our test is successful and the newly created material master record is updated in the third party system. Let us create one new material. I will go to MM01. I will give some number. I will copy from some standard material, existing material, basic data 1, 2. We will select as many views as possible. General data, plant data storage 1 also, warehouse management 2, accounting 1, accounting 2. I will copy from the plant 1000, storage location L003, sales are 1000, distribution channel, warehouse 100, storage type 003 to the same. I will copy this to the same organization levels and create the new material. Okay. I will just change the description or something. Sales are 1, sales are 2, sales general plant data, MRP 1, MRP 2, plant data store, kind of storage 2, where is management 1, accounting 1, accounting 2. Yes. A new material is created with the number MAT351124. So the first step is over. Now, after the newly created material, it will create entries in BDCP2 table for this new material with the processing status as blank. Let us go to BDCP2 table. AC69, put BDCP2 table, put our message type MATMAS underscore 1, execute. Yeah, we can see the entry is created in BDCP2 table with the processing indicator as blank for the material MAT351124. See, why there are so many entries, you will ask me. Because we have the entries for the object key in so many tables in BD52. See, since the creation of a new material has made entries in so many tables for the so many views we created, those entries we can see here for table MARA, MARC, MARD, MBEW, MLGN, MLGT, MBK, all this, and DMAKT and DMLAN. All it has, this is all standard entries. So the processing indicator is blank. Now the first step is over. Second step is we will create a variant and run the background job. After the background job runs, it will create an IDOC and the processing indicator of the entries in BDCP2 table for all columns will change to X. Now we will create a variant and run a background job and see the entries in BDCP2 table. I will create an entry. I will create a variant SC38. Put the program name RBDMIDA. Select radio button variants. This variant is already there. We will just click change. Put the same variant name, change. Message type is MATMAS_1, our custom message type. Click variant attributes. Here the important thing is select only for background processing. This selection, select. Give the some description. Save. Variant MATMAS_1_new, saved. Now we will, the third step, we will run the background job in SM36. Job name, we will use same as the variant name. Click step. Program name is RBDMIDA. Variant is MATMAS_1_new. Click this check. Click save. We will get this step list overview screen. Go back. Click green flag start condition. Click here immediate. There are other options also here like date, time, something like that. So in the real time, that is we need to set this background job for every interval of every 2 hours or 3 hours, 6 hours, depending on the number of records created in the client system. So for our demo, we will click immediate because we will run the job immediately. Click check. Click save. And finally, click here, save at the top. Okay, we got the message, job MATMAS_1_new, saved with status released. That means this background job has created an IDOC for the newly created material, and this must change the entries in BDCP2 table for processing status to X, means process or IDOC is created. Now we will go to BDCP2 table. What we will do, we will just refresh. We will just refresh it. Refresh. Yeah. Now we can see the processing indicator has changed to X. That means IDOC is triggered for this newly created material MAT351124. Now we will check in W02 and see the newly created IDOC for the newly created material. I will go to W02. Today's date, message MATMAS_1, our custom message type, execute. Yeah, we see that the IDOC is already created. We will check the material number in the segment D1 MARAM. Yes, the material, the newly created material MAT351124 is here. So IDOC is created for the newly created material and sent to the third party system. That is, the third party system is updated with the new material master record created in ECC system. If you go to all these segments, we can see the other data. If you see the E1 MARCM, here the plant will be there. Works plant is 1000. So if we go to the other segments, we can see the here in MLGN, we can see the warehouse number. Like this, in the other segments, the other data will be updated. These are all standard segments, standard fields. So the test is successful. We had created a new metal master record in ECC, and the chain pointers settings have created the IDOC successfully, and the third party system is updated with the newly created metal master record. Thank you for watching this session. Please give your valuable comments in the comment section, and you can subscribe to my channel and I am also going to release more such videos soon. Thank you all. Thanks for joining this session.